has prevented us from moving forward on this?
We were too successful. I think we are just at the same thing. I can think about the same with our hotels. You know, there is a lot of things that you feel that are going wrong, but as long as you're successful, you keep on doing it because you don't have time to stop and think and reinvent because you're afraid that, you know, it's an opportunity that you're going to miss stopping what you're doing. But right now we were forced to stop. I think it's a moment in time where we are forced to stop, and it should be a great opportunity to reinvent ourselves. And not everything, because I would say most of the things were very successful, but we knew, like in any organization, there is always that little piece of sand that grinds your organization and it's becoming. And before the COVID-19 crisis started, we knew that transportation was becoming an issue. You know, they keep on making bigger, larger highway, and it's still full, you know, and the number of cars kept on growing and the traffic did not resolve. So obviously, it was something that at some point was going to hold our growth, because you cannot have 10,000 more cars, you know, end of story. So I think maybe that is that moment in time where we say, okay, now we have time, because, you know, it's going to take time. I mean, that economic crisis is not going to be resolved in the next 2 months. So, you know, we have a year, 2 years. So let's start to, you know, take care of that issue and figure out what is the best way to do it. We have drivers, we have people that know the island, and people who have the buses, so we have the equipment, we got everything. We got to have to just, how do we repackage, you know, and repurpose that population, so the small investors, and potentially create a cohesive systems. Right now, it's something that has to be taken with a different approach. It has to be convenient. We have to use technology. It's not just about flagging the bus. I mean, any one of us who travels, we know we all use Uber everywhere we go. Why? Because we can track where the driver's here. When I go back to Paris, I can look on the screen where the bus is arriving next. You know, when the subway arriving, I can contact. I mean, everybody now is on that mode that you know, if you know that the bus is in 5 minutes, I'm going to spend 5 more minutes inside in the air conditioning, and then I'm going to move outside when the bus is here. So I think that there is a way to reinvent and figure out how do we create potentially, and that was kind of the proposal, how do we create something that is still recognizing the opportunity for small investors, but at the same time, potentially put some governmental agency or something that is make it a cohesive transportation, that there is it's an easy from payment to app to usage, and something that I don't have to pull a $1 Caymanian every time I take in a different bus, you know. So there has to be a way that you can package all that to resolve the issue.
Someone's traveled to other, you know, major tourist destinations. How do you feel Cayman compares right now in terms of the transportation options that we can offer people?
I don't even want to compare. I think we want to be better. You know, I mean, we are so advanced in so many other places. We cannot compare ourselves. We got to be better than everybody else. What we need to do is, what we don't do enough, I believe, is showcase what the different facets of the island. And it will help everybody. You know, how do we invent a journey? You know, customers from here could go on a boat and go home to Brom Point, take one of those bus from over there and discover the Crystal Cave or the beautiful East and the North Sound, because nobody goes over there because it takes 45 minutes, and if you charge by a taxi, it's going to be expensive. But there might be a combination that create actually a new full experience. You know, it cannot just be Seven Mile Beach, Stingray City, Seven Mile Beach, Stingray City. There is other beautiful places, the Blowhole, the East End, the South End. There is beautiful places that are a little piece of gem. And then it will be up to, you know, again, entrepreneurship for people to develop and try to, we can market this kind of different subculture of our island. Yeah.